It's a new day. Oh, it's a new time. And there's a new way. Gonna live my life hardy. The past passed away. And the new has come. Thank God it's a brand new day. Thank you for tuning in to the Open Door Ministry Breadcrumbs Podcast with me, your host, Barbara Smith. We are here to share our blog articles with you in an audio format. We know that people are very busy and constantly on the go, but we all still need daily inspiration in our lives. It is our goal to share a few thought-provoking morsels that will challenge you to stay actively engaged in the Word of God. His Word is the bread of life. His Omniscience by Barbara Smith. Our whimsical ideas and self-made patterns often put us in a rut of humanistic achievement, as if our favorite shirt or our lucky sweater will somehow change the course of events in our favor. Yet we continue day by day as if on a hamster's wheel and seeing no progress or fulfillment. The bottom line is that we really do not know what we need without divine assistance. There is a story of a superstitious guy named Frank. Frank believed that 5 was his special number. He was born on May 5th. He had 5 children, and he lived at 555 East 55th Street. At the track on his 55th birthday, he was surprised to find a horse named Numero Cinco running in the 5th race. So 5 minutes before the race, he went to the 5th window and put $5,000 down on Numero Cinco. Sure enough, did you guess it? The horse finished 5th. Poor Frank was a victim of his own limited way of thinking. That is the main problem. We are limited in our thinking. However, God is infinite in wisdom, and only He knows what is truly best for us. Oftentimes, the worst things that happen to us in life turn out to be the best things that happen to us. James chapter 1, verse 2 through 4 says, "Consider it great joy, my brothers, whenever you experience various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces endurance. But endurance must do its complete work, so that you may be mature and complete, lacking nothing." You can keep trying to figure your life out all alone, or choose to follow the leading of the one who is omniscient and who already knows the end of your story. His ways supersede any thought or idea we could ever have. Just because he leads you down a different path today than you went yesterday does not mean it is the wrong one. He knows if there are pitfalls or dangers that you need to avoid that day, at that time, on the old path. Stay sensitive to Him, walk in the Spirit, and let Him lead you each day. David shows us that he has learned this lesson when he penned Psalms 142, verse 3. "When my spirit was overwhelmed within me, then you knew my path. In the way in which I walk, they had secretly set a snare for me." Job stated in Job 23, verse 10, "But He knows the way that I take. When He hath tried me, I shall come forth as gold." He did not feel God while he was going through his trials and tests. He could not see God, but he trusted God because of his past relationship with Him. He was acknowledging that God knew where he was, what was taking place in his life, and that God would take care of his current, albeit temporary, plight. This is what Paul meant when he stated in 2 Corinthians 5, verse 7, "We walk by faith and not by sight." We may not know why God directs us in certain ways or prompts us to do certain things, but we must trust Him because we know He already knows the outcome and has our best interest at heart. Johnson Odom, Jr., born on April the 21st, 1856, born in Medford, New Jersey, along with 3,000 other hymns, penned one that you might know. The chorus goes like this: "Hand in hand we walk each day, hand in hand along the way. Walking thus I cannot stray. hand in hand with Jesus. And where is he taking us when we are hand in hand with him, you might ask? David gives us a glimpse in Psalms 23 when he says, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." God knows what he is doing, and he knows where we need to go. He does not need a GPS to guide him, to show him the way, or the amount of time it is going to take us to get there. He is omniscient. He just knows. Romans 11:33 says, "Oh, the depths of the riches, both of the wisdom and knowledge of God, how unsearchable are his judgments and his ways past finding out." We do not have to worry about figuring anything out because he already knows. You do not even have to pack a sack lunch for the journey. He already has a table spread and cool, still waters for you to drink of freely. We just need to put our hand in his and let him lead the way. It's a new day, always
a new time, never a new way. Thanks for joining us today. We trust you have been nourished and blessed. Always remember the Lord is faithful and his mercies are new every morning. Until next time, God bless.